Hello! Welcome to my life story on Stoneworks, spanning over 3 years. I've already made part one a long time ago, but I'm continuing it. And if you're wondering why I haven't uploaded for a while, it's because I had a script before this, but I didn't like it, and I revised it up to make it look cleaner, organized, and slick. But to not waste time and go over old notes, I'm going to pick off right where we ended. D-Fear. Whoa. One more thing. Like and subscribe, join my Discord, and watch some of my other videos. Oh, and keep in mind, I was just barely 13 when I made D-Fear, and was very retarded. I still am, but yeah. And this isn't going to go into every PvP battle, and just a brief summary of the most important stuff so we can catch up to current day. But let's just get into the story. Brief summary. I joined Wrathnir mid-late July 2021. I joined a town and blew it up. I had some bumps in the road with my nation senate leaders, I decided a fresh new start would be good and moved 100 blocks south and made a new town in the same nation. And here we are, D-Fear. After building a dock and some houses on the 11th of August 2021, I hosted a party and many different people came. We did boat races, gave out drinks, and this had a good effect on our population growth, becoming one of the fastest growing towns within Outvir, the nation D-Fear is in. And then the people across the border attacked. But what really happened was some of my friends in a nearby town came over to the event and attacked my citizens. I'm not sure who hit first, but it was clear that it started a huge drama. I told them to go back to their city and not come into D-Fear for the next 24 hours to hopefully put an end to this drama. But Orbit decided to come back and continue to harass and attack us. We got three citizens and went to their nearby outpost that they created in the forest to stop our town's expansion. We sat down while they were on their walls and they chased us back to our town, killing us. We didn't even attack them first. No action was taken against Orbit Popcorn, Smocks, or any of their goons. We thought our government had failed us, and all of our citizens were mad. There was this one citizen who even planted TNT under their outpost. His name was Dandy Linker. His name will be important later. Not really. After a week of growth for D-Fear, one of my citizens, Hydro, messaged me that Dandy Linker was planning on overthrowing me and taking over D-Fear, revolting it from Outvir, which will almost certainly lead to its destruction. I made a plan with Hydro to lure him into a drown tank and drown him. I did not like people revolting. This plan worked very easily. All we had to do was say it was a redstone tube and that he had to get into it. He was executed on the 23rd of August 2021. After drowning him and throwing him off a building, I made a political announcement on his exile. During this time, I was attacked by him and lost all my gear. This was about 40k worth of things, and in today's money, in today's Stoneworks money, that's around 70k. In order to get my gear back, I promised him to give him the ownership of D-Fear in return for my gear. He agreed, and before this deal went down, I messaged Orbit Popcorn on this to make sure he knew that it was a fake deal and went to bed. When I woke up, I was exiled from D-Fear. Despite me informing Orbit on this fake deal, he acted like I never told him anything. And Dandy Linker, the guy who got in a 1x2 drown tank, put out a declaration of independence as the mayor of D-Fear. I don't know why I didn't message one of the actual government officials in Outvir, but during the first D-Fear party that was thrown, I had a Discord and named myself king. Early on this time, I didn't fully understand what being a mayor in a nation was like. I thought it was okay. And the Outvir emperor, Jabberdrake, didn't like that and called me out on it. And it seemed like he was trying to take control away from me, and I didn't like it. They saw me more as a troublemaker than an actual asset. So despite me sharing my side of the story to the Outvere government, they would not listen. Luckily, out of all the people who ran for D-Fear's new mayor position, I was able to rig it just enough to have my loyal citizen Hydra win. Because school was going on at the time, and they said I wasn't able to run for office, I was actually okay with it. I was really busy in real life, so I supported the elections. But after the elections, they kicked me out, made me KOS, executed me, lured me back to my own town, kicked me out after I gave them ownership, and even later on nuked the Discord of D-Fear because I had ownership. Because of my betrayal to the Outvere Empire, I was now KOS, kill on sight. Smox, Orbit, and their goons would now be constantly searching for me, along with the Outvere soldiers. After getting my gear out and sailing far, far away with help from Hydro, I made a base that lasted for about 2 months before being discovered by Smox and his goons. I made another base, but this time underwater with my dog. During those 2 months, I would be grinding and eventually got a netherite set and made some more connections. I was contacted by a mayor inside Outvere that was planning for a revolution and wanted me in. This was my chance. This was my chance to get back into D-Fear. How bad did I want it? I wanted it really bad. This revolution had lots of backing. The two other leaders in this revolution were in a similar situation as me. We raised an army totaling over 50 volunteers, while the Imperial Outvere army had raised a force of around 75 to 83 troops. And the battle was set. Just a week before the battle, and after almost a month of preparations and building defenses, getting all the sets we needed, one of the diplomats inside Outvere, Skinny, convinced me to surrender the fortress and end hostility. In return, I'd be able to rejoin Outvere as a citizen and prove my loyalty to rejoin D-Fear. I quickly accepted and rejoined. Who would have guessed having a revolt going on inside your nation would impact how other nations view you? In order to return to D-Fear, I had 3 months of proving my loyalty to Outvere, which was now known as Astilia, united with the northern nation Yimi Audul. During this time, I became a factory worker and a house builder for a town called Landstein, which will be important later. During this time was also when I made videos to prove my innocence as best as I could, because many people still hated me. And as such, I was able to rejoin D-Fear on the 4th of March, 2022, but it was too late. By the time I rejoined, it was a mess. There was no active citizens, only some new houses that lay empty, and I was told that I would be the new mayor, but I would have to run under Smox and Orbit. Under Hydro's leadership, D-Fear was united into one claim, meaning I don't exactly have a say what happens inside D-Fear. They can kick me out anytime they wanted. After myself going inactive for 2 weeks because of IRL reasons, I came back to find Astilia collapsed, as well as Outvere and D-Fear under threat. I did my best to talk them out of it, but they denied. They wanted me gone for good, and the problems that came with me, including D-Fear. They were planning on splitting D-Fear about 70-30 between the two ex-provinces of Outvere, Lyrgal and Valstron. I tried. I really did. I tried. I'll just do this one last one. One more revolution. Where is the sun that shone on my head? The sun in my life. It is dead. Where is the light that would play in my street? And where are the friends I could meet? I could meet. Where are the girls I left far behind? The sticks and the spades. Because I wasn't the claim owner, they were able to start demolishing D-Fear, and I was kicked out, along with all of the citizens in that area. I had to find a claim to declare war on them, and the only option was a friend up north in the nation Karn, a former Alvir province, Landstein. This would be bad because it would spark Karn against me, but I had no choice. You see, when Dífir declared independence from Lyrgell and Valstron, that initiated an old treaty defense pact between the old provinces of Alvir, meaning attack on one is an attack on all, and not to mention the allies they were bringing in. They brought in Kingdom of Haven against me. They publicly denounced us, calling us squatters. I was able to convince four of the nations in the treaty to sit this battle out, including Karn. Now the race was on to see how much money I could get and to hire mercs before the war started. Luckily, my now friend, the diplomat from Alvir, who convinced me to end hostilities back in the second Alvir Revolution, was quietly helping me hire mercs along with defenses. The defenses were done. Traps built, mercs hired in weeks in advance. We were ready. I've already made a video explaining this battle before, so you should go watch that. But the day of the battle was on the 19th of May, 2022. Our army size was about 43 troops, while they had around 85. If more showed up, it would have been a 45 v 125. Big war. We may have a chance, considering the skilled mercs we hired and that we are the defenders, but only time will tell.
As the sun rises on the day of the battle, a soldier writes down his thoughts in a book. His breath is easily seen in the early morning frost. He wonders if they have a chance of winning, if this is all for nothing, or if he will even live.
The siege of Landstein and the war for Dífir's independence had begun. After 5 minutes of waiting for their attack, our scouts had received info of a large army approaching. The mercs had left the walls planning an ambush on them in the narrow valley/forested area, while the less experienced stayed back on top of the walls. The mercs were slowly being pushed back by the overwhelming odds. They were able to push back the mercs to the gates of the walls, where booby traps were laid. Most of the mercs were able to get back inside the walls and continue the fight on the fallback line. However, the soldiers were being flanked and pushed back, and then slowly the mercs started vanishing. The enemy was becoming overwhelming and slaughtering us all, until eventually it just became a killing ground. The battle lasted about 17 minutes. Almost as soon as the battle started, it was over. The mercs were in a separate VC, leading to communication problems. The reason why the mercs left is because the admins told them to leave the battle or face mass bans. The reason was because the Horde merc group helping us would be out of character and not allowed. While the merc group was leaving, they turned off the war command, but killing people would still drop loot. The coalition forces continued to attack our confused troops, killing many and a loss in so much loot, over 350,000. Before the war command was turned off, the battle deaths were the following. But it was 23 dead Dífir soldiers and only 7 dead coalition troops. A crushing defeat, no matter the circumstances. Because of how long the war took, many Dífir citizens quit. And after this battle, it was final. Dífir was lost. Despite me wanting to continue the war, the owner of the claim, my friend, sold it to the enemy. And the admins wouldn't give me the gear back from the people who lost it when the war command was turned off. I was lost. What was there to do now that my town was gone? Despite it being a small town, I loved it and latched onto it, which is something I now regret. From the founding of Dífir to the end, I fought tooth and nail for it for 8 months. The merc group, feeling bad, offered me a province inside their nation. I accepted and formed the Dífir province. Starting up was kind of hard. Any citizens I could recruit, quit. And clearing out the ruins of a past town took a while. But after the capital of Dífir was set up, Muntar, things were looking good. And after fighting for the Horde in the Battle of Sarvinia, I was able to secure some funds to build more houses. But it wasn't enough. I was constantly broken talking with my friends in Galadon. I realized that the market game wasn't exactly big. There was only a handful of markets, and all of them were nice and not attacking each other. So I decided, what if I didn't follow the rules? What if I did whatever I could to make money while keeping my customers safe? The other markets didn't care about their customers. They just let them die, even killing some of them time to time. I needed the money, and I wanted the fame. I wanted to be the biggest. If I couldn't make a nation, then I'll try with a market. And so it was. Dragon's Mart was born.